At Comic-Con, DC announced two new projects from the legendary Grant Morrison. And we got to talk to the man himself to find out all about his latest masterpieces.
So Comic-Con is always the time to announce new projects.
Yeah.
Tell us, what exactly is Multiversity 2?
Well, Multiversity 2 is basically an idea that Dan DiDio had, although I came up with the idea and put it in the Multiversity series. Dan just said, you've got to do something with this. You can't just say there's another multiverse out there and do nothing with it. And I went back to Dan and said, well, there's not just another multiverse, there's as many as we need. You know, there's like little champagne bubbles in a glass. It was just something I thought, well, yeah, okay, I'll get back involved in that. Because I've got a bunch of stories that don't quite fit into continuity that I've always wanted to tell. And this was an opportunity to do those things and find a home for them. I came to Dan with a Flash story that I wanted to do, and Dan said, well, that's perfect. That can be the first of the Multiverse 2 titles that you're doing. It's just a story I've always wanted to tell. It's kind of a love story of the Flash, and it takes it away from the superhero thing, and it's just about the basic story of he's a scientist getting faster and faster. And at the end of that, the upper limit, that's the speed of light, where matter can't exist and time comes to a stop. So it's really a love story, a kind of Groundhog Day thing about this guy getting faster and faster and his girlfriend trying to deal with it. And I'm doing a Batman Black and White book with a bunch of alternative artists from Los Angeles, and we're kind of doing a bunch of different versions of Batman. Once we start expanding out there, I think it'll get quite weird. The Batman book is quite strange, you know, it presents very unusual versions of Batman.
Do readers have to have read the Multiverse main title to be able to jump into Multiversity 2?
No, these are stories we want to be able to tell from the ground up. If you've never seen these characters before, you'll have a complete adventure. You'll get to know the characters. You don't have to know anything prior to that at all. But obviously, it takes place in the wider canvas of the DC multiverse.
So let's get more into Batman Black and White. You said things get super weird.
Yeah.
What can you tell people about that title?
Well, I'll tell you, basically, it was I've got a lot of friends in Los Angeles who are part of the alternative art scene, and they're really amazing painters and photographers and designers, and they've always wanted to do comics, but none of them have ever had the chance to do it. So I said, would you like to get involved in this book? So we thought, well, this will make it look quite unusual and interesting, because nobody's really let these guys loose on characters like this before. There's a couple of comics artists in there as well, like Bill Sienkiewicz and Ivan Reis are going to do stories. But basically, it's just weird tales of Batman. And one in particular, Alan Amato, the photographer, is doing this kind of photo strip with me. And there's a girl playing the Batman character in that, and it's a model called Elizabeth Evans. And she actually went to a trainer, and she's got herself like buffed up like Batman. It's scary. So they've made this huge, amazing kind of fetishistic bat costume for her, and it looks amazing. So it's kind of, we're just going to weird places with Batman, and there's a Batmite story in there and stuff like that. So.
Will we recognize any of the villains, or who is Batman going to be going up against?
We've got a character in that story called Moonface, which is like Two-Face, but it's a woman who's got like the phases of the moon, so the darkness crosses her face. So at the start of the month, she's good. By the middle of the month, she's half good and evil. By the end of the month, she's completely evil.
Oh,
so it's kind of
cool.
We're just taking kind of Batman ideas and doing them in a different way. So yeah, there'll be a couple of villains you recognise, but mostly we're doing new twists on things.
So what else is going on for you? Because just chatting with you, I'm sure there's so many other things swirling around in your head as well right now.
Yeah, well, there's a million things. I mean, especially for DC, I'd like to do a story with the Atom. You know, for a long time I've had a story with that character, which is, it didn't fit into any continuity. So mostly I'll just be, you know, this is me at the start of this, so I'm just kind of checking out. I'm going back through my notebooks and all the stuff that I didn't get to do, I suddenly now have the chance. Things that didn't fit into continuity or fit into the way things were going at the time are now open. It's open season on any weird idea.
So Grant Morrison's projects are still a little bit of a ways off, but right now, you can head to your local comic shop and pick up Justice League number 42. Make sure that you guys click subscribe, because you can check out some hands-on gameplay of LEGO Dimensions tomorrow on DC All Access.